In this video, I'm going to show you how to make your own mandala design and your own mandala dotted design, which was one of the trends on my Redbubble video earlier. We're going to do this in Affinity Designer. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts, the channel all about helping you design and sell t-shirts online. If that's something you like to do, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. So in this video, I'm so excited to show you how to make your own mandala design, and I'm going to do it in Affinity Designer. So if you don't have Affinity Designer, you may want to pick it up just for this tutorial, because you can make so many mandala designs with this, it will probably pay for itself. You're going to be amazed how easy this is. I'm going to teach you about symbols, which I haven't showed before. And once you learn this trick about symbols, your mind will be changed for Affinity Designer forever. This is incredible. You don't want to miss this. You're going to want to stay till the end, because I'm going to show you how to do a traditional mandala design as well as a mandala dotted design, which was one of the trends in my Redbubble video right here. So stay tuned for that, as well as another edition of Trend Credits. So this is a cool video. You don't want to miss it. Let's get started. All right, so here we are in Affinity Designer. We're gonna do some fun stuff today. So first, we're gonna do the star tool, and that's normally under your triangle tool. So let me go back to triangle here, and then click on the triangle tool, and then scroll down to star tool. And then you're gonna wanna hold down shift while you drag. So I'm holding down shift, and then I'm dragging like this, and just wanna make it inside there. As big as you can to fit the space. I have my artboard at 5400 pixels by 5400 pixels. That's about the size of a Merch by Amazon t-shirt, so that's why I did it that size. You can make whatever size you want. Here we go. The next thing you want to do is to change these points. We don't want 5 points. You can do anywhere between 12 and 36. I'm going to pick 24, and you're going to see it can work with any size, but here's 24. And this is basically gonna be our guides. So make sure that you have this turned on to about 0.4, 0.3 is fine. Make sure this fill is a color and this stroke is a color. So stroke swatches, you can pick black or whatever it is you wanna pick. And then once you're on that star, make sure the radius, you can see it's 38%. We're going to take that all the way down to zero. Basically just using this as a guide. So you can see here, because I have the stroke and color on here, you can still see it. I think the fill, yeah, you're going to need the stroke on, not just the fill. So let's turn that stroke on. So basically we're just going to use this as a guide. The next thing we're going to do is make a rectangle. So I'm going to zoom in just a little bit. We're going to put the rectangle at the top here, and I'm going to drag it. Here's the rectangle tool right on the above the circle tool, right? It's called rectangle tool. And you're going to make your rectangle about this size right here. And one thing you may want to do, you don't have to do this, but this helps so that you can see what I'm doing, is I'm going to make it a gradient. So I'm going to go from here to here, and it doesn't matter what gradient it is. This is just for a visual. So this can be any gradient. The next thing we want to do is we're going to start making this a symbol. So click here. If you don't have symbols here in your palette, you can go to View, Studio, and then click Symbols right here, symbols. So symbols is what's going to make this possible. So if you haven't used symbols before, don't worry, we're going to use symbols today, and you're going to see the power of symbols. This is incredible thing that Affinity Designer does. This can be used for patterns as well. I mean, this is going to be a pattern, but you can use it for other patterns as well. So symbol, you can see here, this is a symbol. I'm going to create a symbol. You can see now this one, this gradient one, is a symbol. Now that we have that symbol, we're gonna hit Option and drag like this, and then we're gonna flip it, and then make sure that they're butt up against each other. You might wanna have this turned on, this enable snapping. That's just gonna help you snap to the different points. So turn that on,
and I have both of them here. You can see one right next to the other. They're mirrored, right? They're mirroring each other, and that's going to help a lot when we're doing our mandala design, because we want it mirrored against this line. So everything we draw is going to be mirrored against this line right here. So that's why we have this guide. So we're going to select both of them here, and we're going to group them. So that's Command G. And after we group them, we're going to copy this and rotate it around what we just did at the guide. So we're going to have to go back out a little bit. We're going to move that center point. You see that center point right here? It looks like this. If you don't have it turned on, you can enable Transform Origin. Turn it on and off right there. That's what that's for. And then we're going to take that, hold Shift, and drag it all the way to the center. And it should lock because we have snapping enabled. It shouldn't lock right there, but if you want to make sure, we can zoom in here and you can see, oh, it's not. There it is. You see those lines? That means that it's locked right there. So that's going to be the center that we're going to rotate this on. Okay, so we're going to rotate this on center so that it goes all around. You'll see what I mean. So the next thing you want to do, now that you have this group selected, is hit Command J. Okay. You may not see anything, but if you go to the layers, you can see that there's two now, two groups. And we're going to rotate it. So right here, you'll see this turns into, look at my arrow at the top here. It's turning into a move to like two arrows, kind of going, doing like this, right? A curved arrow. So wait till you see that and hold Shift and drag it to the right. And you can see it's going to snap to that line, right? And now that you got one of them and you did the Command J, you can hit Command J again and it's going to do it again and again and again. So keep hitting Command J until you get around to the top here, and there's all of your things. So it may not look like anything right now, but this is the base of what you need to create your mandala design. The next few steps are going to blow your mind. So you're going to have to scroll down. I'm going to take my face off of this just for a little bit. So this is just so you can see right here. I'm going to open up the bottom group so you can see that's the original group right here. Open it up, and this symbol right here, you're going to want to open that up and click on that rectangle in the symbol. So this is the original rectangle right now, okay? So now that you have that, click on the pencil tool right here, and you're going to want to make sure that the pencil tool has a width. So let's try 6 point right here. So I made it to 6 point. I'm going to bring back my face. So now that you have the pencil tool selected here, we're just going to draw inside of this. So we're drawing inside this symbol. So that's what's happening. So what's going to happen right here is we're creating the symbol. And remember, all of these are the same symbol. So what symbols do is if you make one, it's going to copy what you did on one symbol on all the other symbols. Because these are all symbols, they're going to copy what you draw here, and you'll see what happens. So remember, this is a mirror image, and then these two are copied, so they're going to be the same. So here's what we're going to do. Pencil tool, and then just start drawing. I'm going to start drawing from the bottom here, and look what happens. I'm just moving my mouse in and out and doing this kind of thing. So look at that. Is this crazy or what? This is how easy it is to draw a mandala design. I'm just going to go up like this. And if there's a space you want to come down, just do that. Come back up and around, whatever you want to do. And you can do this over and over again. And that's it. And then you may not want these things, so you're going to turn those off. So I'm going to go back here. I'm going to move my face again so you can see what I'm doing on my layers palette. So the original star that we made as a guide, turn that off. And the original rectangle that we made, turn that off. And what you're left with is this beautiful mandala design, right? So you can continue to add more and more things here. Just click on the pencil again, and then maybe you want us fill in this space here. Just go like that. Fill it in. Maybe there's a space right here you want to fill in. Fine, just go like that, you know? Do you want to add more up here? Sure, do like that. How about a circle up here? Well, just draw it. Look at that, it's so crazy. So you can have endless amounts of mandala designs here. Each one will be different, and you can just play around with it. So that is how easy it is. Once you get everything set up, that's how easy it is to make your own mandala design. And look how cool that is. You'll have an original design every time because all you're doing is moving things around. So have fun with this. This is a really cool idea that you can do and make lots of, this would be great for pop sockets on merch by Amazon. This would be great for stickers on Redbubble. Also make a cool design for t-shirts. And if you make enough of them, you can make patterns and put them inside of animals and shapes and things like that. So really cool, right? So I promised you to do another one, but with circles. So this is the original mandala design. The trend was mandala dotted design. So let me show you what I'm gonna do with that. So I made another artboard here. We don't have to go through the whole thing, but you can see it's set up again with the star lines, the guides here, as well as the symbol. So this is a different symbol. I'm gonna, instead of drawing with the pencil tool, I'm gonna use circles instead, okay? So let's see how that works. So I made sure to pick that symbol again. So this, remember, this symbol is rotated. So I'm gonna do the circle, and I'm gonna do the circle right here. You can see those are circles. I'm gonna zoom in so you can see. I don't need this stroke here. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna move the circle. I'm gonna move it until they are on each other, and then I'm gonna make it bigger. I can hold down shift and make it a little bigger, and then kind of drag it in so that it doesn't repeat. So you can do the same thing. I'm gonna hold down option. Well, let's change this color so it's not a gradient color. I'm just gonna make it a solid color so you can see that. And so I'm gonna hold down option, and I'm gonna bring it here, right? And then I can make bigger ones and smaller ones. If I want to make a bigger one, I can do it here again, and then hold down option, make it bigger, and then kind of just play around with it. If I want some small ones, I can go here. So I could take this circle here and drag it down. You can see there, and I could make it smaller too. So if I want to make it smaller enough to fit two in there, I could do that. And if I want this small one up here, let's say I want to make it go around it. So I'm going to do that. And then I could do this and maybe do that. You can see what I'm doing there. Maybe a top one up here. Look at that. So that's kind of turning out like that. So you can see I'm making a mandala design just with circles or dots. And you can do your own pattern. You can play around with it. Just have fun with it. You can do a new one every time and change the colors. I'll show you what I did here. I actually made one here, just using that same idea, right? Smaller circles, bigger circles, changing the colors. Look at that. Isn't that a cool design, a mandala dotted design? So that's how easy that is, just using the same techniques. And again, so you can use any number. I use 24 for my star, but if you wanted to do a 20-pointed star or you wanted to do a 36-pointed star, it will change the way this looks too. So have fun with this. The possibilities of this is endless. So hopefully this was really educational for you. Let me know in the comments if you like this tutorial. If you have used symbols before in Affinity Designer, you can see how powerful this is. How it makes everything easy just with a click, you make a whole pattern of different things. So symbols are great. Thanks so much for watching this video. Hopefully it was really helpful for you. And your reward for staying to the end is another edition of Trend Credits. Thanks for staying to the end for this trend credit. Here is your trend. My green jacket is in the wash. So, of course, this is the golf reference, green jacket, right, to win the Masters. So you can see some low BSRs here. Super funny, very relatable for golfers. I think this would be a great present for them. And let's check Merch Informer. It is getting an A, so you know it's good. If you don't have Merch Informer, I have a link in the description for Merch Informer. I believe they're still having their big sale, so make sure to get Merch Informer if you don't have it already. Again, here is your trend. My green jacket is in the wash. You're gonna wanna do yours different than this. Of course, make this for golfers, right? So it's something that they would wanna wear. Of course, they're gonna wanna wear it because of the saying, but you also want to make it look nice so they would want to wear it too. So do something different than these. Make sure that it's nice and appealing for someone to wear as a gift when they're out golfing maybe, or out with friends. So that is your trend. Thanks so much for watching.
And that is it for this video. Hopefully this video is really helpful for you. If it was, make sure to give it a like. And if you're not subscribed already, make sure to hit that subscribe button. And if you like that video about designing things, here are more videos for you to learn how to design other things. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.